r/AskReddit. People of Reddit, what is the strangest way you have died inside one of your dreams? I was beaten to death by hundreds of M&Ms. Oh god. Mom found the M&M sock. Were they melted? I was about to be pushed off a bridge. Then I realized I was dreaming and just swapped places with a guy trying to kill me. And pushed him instead. And one time I dreamt I was Garfield driving a big truck off a bridge. You are the second person that has a dream death in which Garfield is involved. I'm noticing a strange trend here. r/Im's origin. Forgot my wallet at home during a zombie apocalypse and so I couldn't pay to get on the plane to safety. But why would they charge during apocalypse? They'd charge triple. My mom fed me to a whale. WTF. Brain. WTF. Brian. WTF Richard. Found myself in a room with my clone. I strangled her to death and for some reason that also killed me and my mind was stuck in my lifeless corpse. A scientist entered and carted our bodies out. What the duck? I have weird dreams. I got shanked by that one Jewish boy from the boy in the striped pajamas. Shanked my shmuel. I can't believe I laughed so hard at this. I'd give you silver or gold but I'm broke. Getting chased by Obama. Tom and Jerry style. Bonga dalang bonga dalanga. Hi again. Pinned down by two heroin addicts and they injected me until I died. That was also the first time I encountered sleep paralysis. Nasty stuff. In one of my sleep paralysis dreams, my brother put a needle in my armpit and shoved it all the way down my arm. Oh, sleep paralysis dreams. You kinda get used to them, I guess. Sleep paralysis happens when you are awake. No? I can't recall any weird ways I've died right now. But I can recall many weird ways I didn't die in a dream. Had a dream once where I repeatedly stabbed myself in the abdomen before a friend's wedding. Then proceeded to attend the ceremony. With only a towel keeping myself from bleeding out. Woke up feeling a stabbing pain in my abdomen and felt pure horror as I checked it for the wound. Dreams are whack. Man. I can't recall ever dying in a dream. But I've had dozens of dreams where I miraculously survive very deadly situations. Including one where I was dragged behind a car on a highway for at least a couple miles. Then was thrown into an intersection. I just got up and walked away. Then he waddled away. There's a famous bridge near me that for some reason I'd bought for 2p. As me and the family were going to look at my new purchase. A cavalier jumped out and stabbed me in the stomach with his sword. I was really young at the time but I remember it vividly. I pictured LeBron leaping out with a sword. I pictured a Chevy Cavalier. My teeth fell out then for some reason a wild pack of dogs ripped me apart. Hit. That's a rough one. Sounds like a stress dream. Dreams about teeth falling out almost always happen during times of serious financial stress. My personal favorite is where I wake up from a bad dream and all the bad stuff didn't happen and my life is normal but I don't realize that this too is actually a dream and I'm still asleep. That little bit of relief and breakthrough before more bad hit happens makes the second round of bad hit seem way more real. I have had levels of this. It isn't always scary either. Some can feel nice and comforting then. Wait, you don't have green eyes. Oh duck, this isn't real. This one reminds me of a dream I had all but blocked out of me memory. I had woken up from a nightmare about being trapped in an old house surrounded by zombies. And they were starting to break through the walls when I woke up. I looked across the room and the dim light that came in around the edges of the blinds from the street light outside. And I noticed that there was a set of what looked like white plastic coveralls hanging next to the door. They weren't there before. Which creeped me out. So I resolved to go over to them and confirm that there is nothing wrong with them. Just to put myself at ease so I could go back to sleep. I got up and went over to them. Poking the area where the belly would be to confirm that they were empty. They were not empty. And the occupant's left hand clamped down on my right arm and pulled me close. I distinctly remembered the maniacal look on his face as he stared into my eyes before I woke up for real. It would be several hours after that before I could accept that I was actually awake and not dreaming. And for several weeks I would check to see if I was really awake if I woke during the night. While I didn't die in this dream, I have not been so deeply affected by a dream in my adult life. I looked up at the sky as the sun exploded like a supernova and everything around me obliterated like that scene in Inception and woke up in a cold sweat. It was crazy. Crushed to death by a giant living donut. I have no idea what this means for me. XD. Death by Homer. I was like 10 at the time. And I had a series of connecting dreams about me being a bear and running away from a hunter trying to shoot me. He always did. The hunter looked kind of like a classic hunter character from a kid's comic or something. White jungle hunter hat. Beige clothes. I don't think I ever really saw his face. He had a rifle. One time. I was running away from him and I went through a playground I knew well. It was from real life. And I met a black panther who was hiding under a big step. She, female voice and feminine eyes lol, said something snarky about me. And I got annoyed and quickly kept running away. I think she also got shot by the hunter. I don't quite remember. Well. For some reason got into a kind of void room. It was just gray. It didn't really have any outlines. Just gray walls. Floor. And ceiling. I didn't see a door anywhere. I was just there somehow. The hunter's daughter was there too. I think she had a ballet dress, pink skirt and such, but I don't really remember. The daughter was standing in front of me, refusing to move. The hunter just ducking shot through her head. She was dead. She just stood there, with a hole in her head. I could see through it. Red blood dripping inside it. The rifle's shot didn't even touch me for some reason. I think I had moved to the side. Unfazed. He just kept trying to shoot me. I, for some reason, thought it was a good idea to ballet dance to the side when he shot me. But it still went through my head. Suddenly I was in third person mode and saw myself with the same hole as the hunter's daughter. I was still a bear. Then I woke up. Damn, what a story, and really brutal for a 10-year-old. It is really strange how we can remember our dreams so clearly sometimes. Yeah. I guess. I was kinda badly bullied then by a mean boy. And I thought that I was fat and ugly and generally disgusting. That wasn't really his fault. As he never said that. He was just an asshole in so many different ways. He ducked with my mind. The teachers tried like everything. But gave up after a year and a half. I had super low self-esteem. 2 years later. I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety. A lot of things had happened when I was in 6th grade. And I was still kinda dealing with me having been bullied. I suspect that I had some kind of depression and or anxiety then. But I just thought it was normal. I got a really high score on the depression test. I was suicidal as hell too. But I didn't explicitly say that. This one time I had a dream where I got killed by a three-headed Snow White. But one of the faces was my mom's. Without a doubt the weirdest dream I've ever had. Three-headed things often represent pent-up sexual anxiety. Everybody gangster till op has Oedipus dreams. I was an astronaut on a spaceship and dropped my jar of Skippy peanut butter out an opening hole of the ship I was on. The other astronauts around me were trying to stop me from leaving the ship to go get it, but I refused and jumped out of the spaceship to get it. Then I realized my body wasn't tethered to the ship, so I was doomed to drift away and die into the empty void of space. Upon this realization I screamed "Nyuuuu!" in slow motion Darth Vader style. Did you get the peanut butter? I woke up before I was able to grab it. Humanoid crocodile man who looked like a cross between Spike from Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Killer Croc bit off my arm after I tried to go to my non-existent basements for some Cocoa Puffs and found my way into his lair instead. That didn't kill me. I died of poison from the Cocoa Puffs. Pregnant dreams are a trip, dude. During a dream I got up from the exact bed I was sleeping in. Went to the kitchen to drink a glass of water and when I returned back my sister stabbed me in my right armpit. Finn. This makes me laugh every time. Like WTF brain. What did she say in her defense the next morning? Yeah, I would like to know also. I was in Publix and was crushed by a falling display of potatoes. Thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe to Reddit Queen for the best daily content.